Good morning, students. Okay, in the last video we have seen about, we have done the activity of the sowing the seed. Yes or no? Many students have done that activity. Have you enjoyed that activity? Yes. Okay, now related to that, today we are going to learn the lesson number 2, that is growing the plants. Okay, in this video we are going to discuss the many points. So I'll just recall what points we are going to discuss. We are going to discuss about growing the plants with the help of the seeds. How does the dispersion of the seeds takes place? So you must have seen the different types of the plants in your garden, in your school garden, everywhere. Am I right? You have seen the different types of the plants, and there are the every plant is different. But can you just tell me why the plants are important? Is it necessary to grow the plants? Give me the answer. Yes, plants are very important. Why the plants are important? Plants are important because the each and every part of the plant is useful. Yes or no? Plants gives us medicine. Plant gives us food, vegetable. The wood of the plants is very important. We can make the furniture. In villages, the wood of the plant is, villagers take the wood and they burn. And after burning, they can prepare their food. Yes or no? So each and every part of the plant is important. So the main important thing of the plant is that the plant gives us what they gives? Air and oxygen, which is very important for the human being. So for each and everything we depends on plants. But have you imagined or have you ever think that how does the plants grow? Yes, have you ever imagined? Yes, yesterday you have done the activity. Yes or no? You have sown some seeds. Yes? Yes. So the plants grow with the help of the seeds. So see, the plants which grow with the help of the seed, the seed help us to plant to grow. Yes or no? So that process is called as a reproduction. That process is called as a reproduction. Have you ever seen the seed? It is very small. The seeds are very small. Then how does it help? See, have you seen the watermelon and papaya? Have you ate the watermelon and papaya? Yes, when you open that watermelon and papaya, then you can see the tip. You can see the many seeds. You can get a many seed in the watermelon and papaya. The seeds are very small. Yes or no? And when we throw it out, then each and every part, whatever the seed you threw it out after eating the papaya and watermelon, when you throw that seed, the each and every part or every seed does not grow. Do you know why? If we will throw all the seed at one place, then whether they will grow? No, they will not grow, because every seed will not get a proper nutrient and water. So they will not grow. So to grow the seed, the seed needs proper water, then nutrient, and also the proper atmosphere. They should get a proper sunlight, then only the seeds can grow. Are you getting this? Now see, we will learn about the structure of seed. Have you seen the seeds? Seeds are very small. Yes. Then the outer covering of a seed is called as a seed coat. What it is called? Seed coat. Then what is the use of the seed coat? Now, okay, for example, I will give an example for you. You are wearing the coat. Then what is the use of the coat? sun coat. Have you seen? Your mother or your father might be wearing while going during the summer vacation, that they are wearing the sun coat. What is the use of sun coat? It protects us from the sun. Yes or no? Like that, the seed coat protects the baby plant. Inside the seed coat, there is a baby plant. So that baby plant is also called as embryo. What it is called? Embryo. Okay, the seed coat protects the baby plant. Okay, then the seed coat has a tiny hole. The seed coat has a tiny hole. Then what is the use of that tiny hole? The tiny hole, because of that tiny hole, the seed, the baby plants can get air and water. Baby plants can get the seed coat. Inside that seed coat, who is there? Baby plant. And seed coat has a tiny hole. In that tiny hole, the baby plant, because of that tiny hole, the baby plant can get air and water. Okay, then in the other part of that seed coat, there is a scar. That is a scar. What is the why there is a scar? It is, scar is nothing but it attached to the plant. Scar is nothing but it is attached to that particular plant. Then along with the seed coat, there is a seed leaves. Seed leaves is also called as a cotyledons. What it is called? Cotyledons. Inside that seed coat, there is a seed leaves, and that is also called as a cotyledons. So what is the use of cotyledons and seed leaves? Can you just tell me? Yes, the use of that seed leaves and cotyledon is that it stores the food for the baby plant. It stores the food for the baby plant. So once again, I will revise the, what is the structure of the seed? See, seed is covered with the outer covering, that is called as a seed coat. It is called as a seed coat. The inside that seed coat, there is a baby plant, and it protects, the seed coat protects the baby plant. And seed leaves or cotyledon, it stores the food for the baby plant. Now we will learn how does a germination of the seed takes place. Now what is meant by the germination? Germination means what? The growing of the plant from baby plant to the young plant. So that process is called as a germination of a seed. The, once again, see, germination of a seed means what? The growing the plant, growing the seed from the seed, that is from the baby plant to the young plant. So that process is called as a germination of a seed. Then see, how does a plant grow? See, when you will sow the seed, at that time the water will be taken, or water will be taken by the seed coat. The water will be given to the baby plant by the seed coat, and seed leaves and cotyledons will provide a food for the baby plant. After some days, when it will start to grow, when it will get adequate sunlight and water along with the nutrients, it will start to grow. The first stage is that the roots of the plants will grow. The first stage it will grow first root, and root will grow downwards of the soil. And because as soon as the roots will grow, it will provide the water and nutrient to the baby plants. Now here, the seed coat will not provide a water and nutrients to the baby plant. Now who will provide? The roots will provide the water and nutrients to the baby plant. And after some days, the leaves will grow. The shoot part of the plant will start to grow. Shoot part means it is the upper part which grows above the soil. The shoot part of the plant will grow. And as the leaves will develop, the leaves will provide a food for the plant. The leaves will provide the food for the plant. And this whole process is called as a germination of a seed. This process is called as a germination of the seed. Now see, every plant will not grow, means if the seeds which are scattered will not grow. The some seeds will get scattered. Scatter means what? They will move from the mother plant. That process is called as a dispersion of a seed. That process is called as a dispersion of the seed. The some plants means some plants, when we are eating mangoes, or suppose for example when we eat mangoes, we don't throw that seed at particular place. We eat mangoes at our house and we throw nearby them. Am I right? So the this process is called as a dispersion of a seed. The seeds which go away from the mother plant, that process is called as a dispersion of a seed. That process is called as a dispersion of a seed. Now dispersion of the seeds takes place by wind, then by the human being, or by the, we can say, with the help of the water. So dispersion takes place. Now by the wind, see, have you seen the cotton seeds? See, it is very light in the weight, so it can fly with the wind. Somewhere, right? As soon as the air will blow, it will go away from that mother plant and it will germinate, or it will germinate at another place. What will happen if all the seeds will fall near to that mother plant? They will not get proper nutrients and water, so they will not grow properly. Yes or no? So dispersion of a seed is very necessary. Dispersion of the seed is very necessary. Then some parts, that is, if you will take cotton, this takes place with the help of the wind. Then next is with the help of the animal. Now see, now we are also the one kind of animals. Whatever we do not eat the fruit, or whatever the fruits we eat, we do not eat the food in front of the fruits. We will not eat in the particular place. We take that fruit, our apple, whatever we will get from that tree, we will move to that another place and we will have it. Am I right? And after that, we are throwing the seed at particular different place, and because of that, the dispersion of the seeds takes place. This is by the human activity. Then dispersion by the water. Now see, if you will take the lotus, am I right? Lotus. Then the dispersion takes place. It is very light, so it will flow. It is spongy. It's moved to the different place because of the water. The big flow of the water, it will move away from that mother plant, and dispersion of the seeds takes place. So these are some factors through which the dispersion of the seed takes place. Then there is meant dispersion of explosion. Means by the explosion means what? When you split up. When suppose if you will take bean, see this bean. When you will split that bean, it will get into they will get scattered. So that process is called as a dispersion of explosion. So related to this, there are some MCQs. We are going to solve the MCQs. Now see, there are the MCQs which are given in the test book. See this. So this is related to that. We will solve the two MCQs. That is, a baby plant lie between the cotyledons. So tick to the cotyledons. Then the next is, which of the following seed is dispersed by the wind? By the wind, which is that? Cotton. So tick to that cotton. In the next video, we are going to learn how does plants grow from the different parts of the plants, that we will see in the next video. Thank you.